We're on the precipice of a renaissance of TV comedy and drama written, produced, and starring Black British television stars. This industry awakening didn't come easily. It was fought for and hard won by Black British creatives decades before. So to understand where we are now, and more importantly, where we're going, we have to go right back to the earliest example of Black British representation on television. Almost 30 years after the first ever television drama was broadcast, Royal Force Airman turned actor Cyril Grant became the first Black person to be featured regularly on television in the United Kingdom when he starred in the BBC's Man from the Sun. It aired at a time when what we now know as the Windrush generation were arriving in the country by government invitation after the promise of work. The show depicts a group of West Indians as they settle in London, face prejudice from the white population, and attempt to integrate themselves into the existing Black community. For the first time, television mirrored many of the lived experiences of Black people in Britain at the time. But while Man from the Sun showed how television could reflect the lives of Black people in the UK, the Black and White Minstrel Show was evidence of how far television still had to go. The variety show first aired in 1958 and featured musical numbers by performers dressed in blackface. At its most popular, it received 16.5 million viewers an episode. In 1967, more than 200 Black people aligned with Campaign Against Racial Discrimination signed a petition calling for the show's termination.
It is both racist and it is also very patronizing.
I'm not going over the top.
Yet it was defended at the time by people right at the top of the broadcaster. The show remained on air until 1978. Despite the open racial hostility targeted at Black people at the time, Black British people continued to make strides in their representation on television. For example, in 1968, Barbara Blake Hannah became the first Black person to appear on British television in a non-entertainment role as a reporter on Thames TV's daily evening show, Today with Eamon Andrews.
Her name was Barbara Blake and I was that girl.
And in 1973, Sir Trevor MacDonald became TV's first Black newsreader in Britain. With the late 1970s came the first British television series to feature an all-Black cast. The Fosters, starring Lenny Henry and Norman Beaton, aired its first episode in 1976. Based on the American series Good Times, The Fosters hoped to emulate its predecessor's success.
Here's some good news. The value of stocks and shares is going down.
What's good about that?
We haven't got any.
But the British TV series ended in 1977 after only two seasons. It wasn't long before Norman Bateman was back on British television screens. The much-loved actor starred in the seminal 1978 series Empire Road, the first series on British television to be written, directed, and produced by a predominantly Black creative team. While other series like Love Thy Neighbour and Mixed Blessings were expressly vehicles for comedy, Empire Road weaved both comedy and drama to deal with more serious issues.
What the hell you all doing? Who started you? What you two doing in my house?
If the 70s were a step in the right direction, the 1980s were a huge leap forward in the representation of Black people on British television. Moira Stewart became Britain's first Black woman newsreader in 1981. Lenny Henry's comedy sketch show, The Lenny Henry Show, aired for the first time. George Harris was the first Black actor to play a lead in a police drama. And 1982 saw the launch of Channel 4, a broadcaster with a remit to serve underrepresented communities. Classic British soap operas too were finally including Black characters for the first time. EastEnders introduced the Carpenter family in 1985. And in 1988, 22 years after its first episode, Coronation Street welcomed Shirley Armitage, played by Lisa Lewis, to its famous cobbled streets. Shirley dated beloved character Curly Watts, a storyline which producer Bill Podmore said in his memoirs led to letters of such poisonous words because of the romance between a black and a white character. Black representation was enjoying a fruitful decade, but the experiences of the talented actress Eva Motley was a stark reminder of the unique difficulties black women faced, being subject to both racism and misogyny. This is now referred to as misogynoir.
I'll make you wish your mother had a headache the night you was conceived.
Motley, born in Barbados, starred in numerous television series including Only Fools and Horses, Crown Court and Bergerac. In 1983, she played sex worker Bella in the Linda LaPlante adaptation of Widows. During production of the second series of the wildly successful heist-themed drama, Motley left the show alleging sexual and racial abuse by the production team. A week before the release of the second series, she died by suicide. Steve McQueen's 2018 feature-length adaptation of Widows is dedicated in Eva Motley's honour.
Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be able to say to you, welcome to Channel 4.
True to its remit, Channel 4 became the home of breakout television stars, none more genre-defining than writer Trix Worrell, who got his break by winning the channel's competition for debut writers. He went on to create, write and direct Desmond's, a comedy series which still resonates today. Set in a barbershop in Peckham, South London, Desmond's boasted Norman Beaton, Carmen Monroe and Robbie G among its cast.
Am I or am I not Desmond Buffoon, the demon barber?
Well, of course you are, Mr. Ambrose.
Well, in that case, you can cut me in.
Groundbreaking in its depiction of a close-knit Caribbean family, the comedy series ended prematurely in 1994 when Norman Beaton, who played the eponymous character, suddenly passed away. Desmond's remains the standard bearer for black British comedy and is available to watch now on Netflix UK.
What on earth are you wearing, Porkfie? You look like John Travolta in drag.
The 90s began with a bang when the BBC aired the first episode of The Real McCoy. The comedy sketch show starred the creme de la creme of black and Asian British comedy stars. From Desmond's Robbie G to peerless Luella Gideon, Judith Jacob, Mira Sayal and Felix Dexter to name a few, The Real McCoy held no punches and wasn't afraid to experiment with ideas.
My name is Hortense Pretentious.
First airing in 1991, the series regularly drew 5 million viewers and remained must-see TV until it ended in 1996. The impact of the series is still felt today, having paved the way for Asian sketch comedy series Goodness Gracious Me in 1998, and most recently, BAFTA-winning Famalam. While the 90s were a period of enormous advancements, such as girl band Cleopatra's brand new sitcom airing on CITV, the unaddressed issue of British racism continued to rear its ugly, hateful head. In 1993, 19-year-old Stephen Lawrence was murdered in a racist attack by Gary Dobson and Philip Norris. Paul Greengrass's docudrama, The Murder of Stephen Lawrence, starring Marianne Jean-Baptiste and Hugh Quashie as Doreen and Neville Lawrence, was aired on ITV the week before the release of the McPherson Report, a public inquiry into Stephen Lawrence's murder.
My son had a future, and they've taken that away. And I just feel as if they were laughing at us. There's nobody, I think, who looked to pacify me. Nobody could tell me no.
The new millennium should have been an extraordinary time for black British representation on the small screen, But the early noughties saw a drought for black talent on screen, made more uncomfortable by the re-emergence of blackface on mainstream British television in series like Little Britain, The League of Gentlemen, Beau Selector, and The Mighty Boosh. There were some highlights. 2001 saw the first time a group of black British actors helmed a drama series in the adaptation of Patrick Augustus's 1994 novel Baby Father. Starring David Harewood, Will Johnston, Don Gile, and Fraser James, The Observer celebrated the series as a radical drama that swept clichés aside. Directed by BAFTA winner Alric Riley and adapted for screen by Avril E. Russell, Baby Father was a step change in the portrayal of black men and black life in London.
You've been my baby now for 13 years and you'll always be my baby.
Then there was 2003's Three Non-Blondes, a hidden camera comedy sketch series starring Jocelyn Essien, Tamika Empson, and Nemia Benjamin. This was the first all-black women sketch show, and nearly two decades on, the performances remain in a league of their own.
Jesus loves you. Don't you want one?
No, thank you.
What about a flyer? Not anymore. I don't do that.
If you're in the UK, it's another series you can re-watch on Netflix. 3 years later, Essien went on to become the first black woman to write and star in her own comedy series, Little Miss Jocelyn.
I'm really sorry. You're going to have to get the 11:25 or...
An all-black episode of EastEnders in 2009 provided a bleak reminder that there was still a long way to go in equity for black British actors and writers. It was an attempt to give its black cast members more opportunity, but was met with more than 250 complaints. 59 of the complaints were made before the episode had even aired. With high-speed internet changing the game, by the 2010s, young black British writers and directors turned to the digital screen as a way to commission and distribute comedy and drama series that centered their voices. Brothers with No Game, Venus vs. Mars, Meet the Adebanjos, Man Them on the Wall, The Unfamous, and countless others created opportunities for themselves. In 2011, Channel 4 aired the first ever series of Top Boy.
Yo, what going, black?
Wagwan.
No way, I'm in it.
Everyone knows you, Duchenne.
Starring Ashley Walters and Kane Robinson, the series centred around the fictional summer house estate in the London borough of Hackney. After two initial seasons, the show came back via Netflix in 2019, with many returning cast members alongside new breakout talent, including Jasmine Jobson and BAFTA Rising Star Award winner Michael Ward. In 2015, nearly a decade after Little Miss Jocelyn, Channel 4 became home to a then little-known writer, director, and actress's debut comedy series. Michaela Cole's Chewing Gum is an unflinching look at the lives of religiously repressed Virgin Tracy, played by Cole, and her equally awkward sister Cynthia, played by Susan McComa. It's another show you can watch on Netflix UK. Chewing Gum was hugely popular and won Michaela Cole a BAFTA.
You are beautiful, embrace it. You are intelligent, embrace it. You are powerful, embrace it. Thank you.
Her career has continued to blossom. She became the fifth ever woman and only non-white person, black or otherwise, to give the MacTaggart Lecture at the Edinburgh TV Festival.
As a creative, I'm going to do what I do best. I'm going to tell your story.
There, she detailed experiences with sexual assault. Experiences which led to this year's critically acclaimed BBC Three HBO comedy drama, I May Destroy You.
We will show you exactly what we mean by violation.
As a new decade approached, we saw more nuanced intersectional representation. Netflix's own Sex Education centered black characters, exploring blackness in relation to issues such as queerness, mental health, and of course, sex and relationships.
It's okay, but you can't keep on hurting yourself.
Now we're going full circle. Just as 1956, Man from the Sun documented the experiences of settlers from the West Indies, so too did 2020's standalone drama, Sitting in Limbo. The drama tells the story of Anthony Bryan, a black man caught up in the bureaucratic nightmare now known as the Windrush scandal. The BBC drama shone a spotlight on the pain and anguish this scandal caused to those wrongly labelled as illegal immigrants. The representation of black British people on the small screen still has a long way to go, but those writers, directors and actors at the forefront of this much anticipated renaissance have a solid foundation on which to stand. With more channels and the proliferation of streaming services, the opportunities to have comedy and drama series on screen have never been greater.